Good morning, everybody. Today we are here to speak about the CoreSquare tool and share with you some interesting stories we have collected in the last month. With me, there are Claudia. Hi, Claudia. David. Eleonora. And Mattia. Hi, Mattia. And first to start, I'd like to spend a few words to explain what the CoreSquare tool is. So I'm going to share with you my screen so I can share with you the image of the tool. The CoreSquare tool is a tool for lean reputation development. It works on your real capabilities and on the concrete contribution you can give to your community. It follows four leading phases and areas. There are competencies, relationship, contribution, and resonance. And for its nature, it allows a never-ending development path. If you want to know more about the tool, please contact us or watch the video you can find on our Cocoon YouTube channel. David, why did you decide to experience the CoreSquare path? What was your initial intention?
Well, I'm a freelance software developer, and basically this is my first hangout, and this is my first hangout in English, so totally out of my comfort zone. And this is the point. I think that CoreSquare is know your comfort zone, stretch it, and focus with awareness. And this is why I choose to start this path. And when I choose to start, I was looking for new ways of working. And I had a lot of questions in my mind, like what's my goal while working? What I like to do, how can I improve my working, and how can I spend my effort to increase my professional profile. But this question was in the air. I was not able to focus because I was distracted by my daily life. And so I was not able to stop, think, and develop these questions. Also, I was found myself without a tool that could drive me in this internal introspective conversation. And as I said before, I'm a freelancer, so my personal and professional life are really close, so I cannot develop one part and not without the other. And so during my first CoreSquare day, I found that those questions were the starting point for the conversation. And I was able to put all these answers on the ground and starting developing my goal, my professional profile, and all the kind of stuff that I was looking for. And I was very surprised that at the beginning, the question that I was asking to answer was like, what give you energy? Who are you? What do you like about your job? And that was exactly the question I was asking me at that moment. Also, that was also my first time with LEGO Serious Play and Story Cubes that helped me to put on the ground these answers. So I was very, very excited about this tool. And also because I like the lean approach, and to having a tool that can help me to in iterative way to test, measure, and re-asking questions to myself, it was a very, very surprising point for me, and it was what I was looking for exactly. And I'm very curious to see how this path will evolve and how I will evolve with the CoreSquare path. All the questions that I mentioned are very easy, but very hard. Because it's easy to answer, but you are not sure that you are answering the right way. So also, what gives me energy? Yes, I had a lot of thought before, but what I found with the LEGO Serious Play, for instance, were some little details that was, wow, that's the right answer to the question. And now I'm focusing on using these details to increase my daily life.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
So I want to ask to Mattia that 2 months ago had his first workshop, Four Square workshop. I have a point that I want to explore. The first workshop is dedicated to the development of identity for the most part, and to the beginning of the Core Square tool with the first quadrant, that is competencies. So I want to ask to Mattia, what did you learn from this experience that was focused in a so deep way about your identity and about the first quadrant, that is competencies?
Hello, everybody. And yes, I'm a freelancer and I'm trying to be an entrepreneur. But first of all, I'm young and I need to know who I really want to be and what I really want to do. So I think that the first workshop was one of the powerful experiences of my life, because from that day I have started to think more about my identity. So it was the beginning of new reflection about who I am and who I want to be. As David said before, it was useful for me because it helped me to focus my energy, align it with my competences and my identity in general. I have worked during the workshop to establish 2 goals to reach in 4 months, and this helped me to work on my core way. And now, after 2 months, I'm very happy and very satisfied about what happens in these 2 months, and I'm really excited for what will happen. So I'm ready to be surprised again. Simple.
So I have a question, but it's for Ele. And I know, Ele, that you started the Core Square path in October 2017, right?
Yes.
And if you think about yourself on that day and you think about yourself today, what have really changed in your life that you recognize as strictly linked to the Core Square path?
Well, my life has changed dramatically after starting my path with Core Square. I was living at that time a very critical moment, especially under the professional point of view, because I have closed a chapter of my professional life and I needed a new direction. I didn't have precise goals to reach. I was really confused about what I would like to do in my life, in my new phase of in the new phase of my life. Just 2 things were really clear in my mind. First of all, the desire to change, to put out of there, to discover a new direction. And then I was sure to have some inner quality ready to be discovered. So I was really curious to do this path with Core Square. At that time, I was really different. I was insecure and I was really shy. I was afraid of everything because I didn't like to go out of my comfort zone. I didn't like to stay in stranger context. I was afraid, for example, to fail, to disappoint the other expectations, my family's ones, my husband's ones, my colleagues' ones. It was really, really a bad period of my life. Coursera gave to me the opportunity to take my time to reflect about myself, about my desire, about what I would like to do in life. And according to me, it was the best time ever for me. It was a real experience of self-discovery. I have had the opportunity to choose my path, to choose the targets to reach each time, and also to measure them, because I can have the concrete proof of what I could do, and if I had reached or not my goal. I can measure it practically, and it gave to me a great satisfaction. I'm really, really different, because also my relationship with fear has changed. For example, I understood, as a great friend of mine sent to me, that I have to dance with fear. I can control my fear, and I am definitely a better person in my life and also in my profession.
Thank you, Ele, thank you, because share this kind of story is not so easy. So thank you to give us your point of view. Any other question for Ele?
I have a question, but for you, Laura. It's connected to the conversation we are having with the others, but it's different. I want to ask you, what are the aspects of the Coursera model that we have found most powerful, and what have been those most difficult for you to deal with? As the other people explained, the Coursera allow you to face fear, personal aspects of yourself, personal aspects that usually we don't listen in some way. So it's important for me to understand the most powerful part of the Coursera and the most difficult part of the Coursera for you, from your point of view.
Thank you. It's really a great question, really. And so I have found the model very powerful and interesting. I think that it represents one of the most important experiences I've done in my life since now, to be honest, I'm sure of it. I found very interesting all the workshop, and it was very interesting to understand my deep identity, as it was important to extract the main competencies I'd like to highlight. And it was very interesting also set the goals for the next step. But to be honest, I think that the adventure starts after the workshop, when you have to work to reach your goal, when you have to collect all your energy and your attention to your work, and you have naturally to move out of your comfort zone. I found this part of the experience very hard and magnificent at the same time, because for me it was really a coup de moment, and it really changed my perception of myself and of my capabilities. And this part of the experience really moved myself on another level, a higher level. So I really like to suggest everyone to taste the tool, because I think that it can really change a lot of things in our life and in our mind and in our soul. So it's my answer.
Of course, I agree with you, because the workshop is an important step, but then you have to work on what emerged from the workshop. So about your specific goal, the specific goal you have chosen, and the key activities you defined and everything, the will and the effort, the energy to reach this point is all on the person. The facilitator is only a person who helps you, to see something that sometimes is different to see. But of course, the point is you can do the difference, and you have to do it.
Okay, alright. I have a question for you.
Yes.
Because you had your first workshop on October 2015, right?
Right, a lot of time ago.
Really a lot. And then you worked a lot with this tool also as a facilitator. So you have a different point of view on the tool. So what have you learned by this experience, all the people you supported in the last 3 years?
Yes, I experienced it before the Course Square tool on myself. Stelio, and I want to say thank you, Stelio, because he helped me so much, was my coach, my Course Square coach. And in that moment, I discovered the power of the Course Square tool. Then I started to support other people in this path. And in this way, I knew in a different light many persons, many people, so different people. I have so many stories in my head, and so many results that these people reached. Each of these people reached different points, different awareness, different goals. But I have seen that there are some points that are common among all these very different people. The points that are in common is that all of us told me that after the Course Square tool path, or during the Course Square path, they discovered and they reached a new awareness of themselves, a higher clarity of who they are and who they want to be. That is not banal. What you want to be? It's a simple question, as the energy that David explained us are very easy question that we don't ask to ask. We are not used to take our time to explore these important points. After the Course Square, the people say to me, now I have new energy and higher energy and a new will, a new power to reach my goal. Now I want to grow.
Yeah, it's not a question. I would like to thank you, Claudia, because she is my facilitator in this path. And what I found, she put me at ease from the beginning. And I feel a lot of love from her. And this helped me a lot to unlock myself and to be able to focus on the introspection. So it's not easy for me. And I'd like to ask thank you to her because it was very, very powerful.
Any other point?
I agree with David, and I would like to say thank you to Claudia. She's also my coach. And thank you so much because you have given to me the opportunity to challenge me, to discover my limits, to surpass them, and it was a really important thing for me. So thank you.
Thank you so much. The Coursework tool allow you to have a direction, to have a very clear points to reach. And I'm only a tool, another tool for you that make you possible to see something that you have in you.
So thank you, guys. Hello, Claudia, David, Kim.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure to talk with you.
It was a pleasure.